In this illustration, we are going to discuss about the change in orbit of a geostationary satellite. Here, the situation is given as a satellite revolve around a planet in a geostationary orbit of radius r. And it is saying if angular speed of planet about its axis is doubled due to some reasons, we are required to find a new radius of the orbit for a geostationary satellite after increase in the revolution rotation speed of the planet. Now, in this situation here, we can see for a geostationary satellite, angular speed of satellite must be equal to the angular speed of revolution of a planet. So, this omega satellite can be given as the relation we already studied in concept videos, that it is revolution velocity by the radius. So, it is 1 by r root of gm by r, which is equals to the omega of planet for it to be a geostationary satellite. Now, it is given that the angular speed of planet is changed. So, obviously, the radius of geostationary satellite orbit must also be changed to keep it same as the angular speed of planet. So, we can write after increase in planet's angular speed, if we calculate the omega satellite prime, which is a new angular speed for the geostationary satellite, this can be written as 1 by r prime root of gm by r prime. This should be equals to the new angular speed of planet, which is given as twice of the initial angular speed of the planet. If we substitute the values, this 1 by r prime root of gm by r prime is equals to twice of this initial angular speed is 1 by r root of gm by r. The gm gets cancelled out, and on simplifying here, we can see if we square this term, we can write here r prime cube is equals to r cube by 4. That means the new radius of geostationary satellite can be written as r by cube root of 4. That will be the final result of this problem.